Welcome to the beauty of nature in Prairie Creek Redwoods State Park. This is a John's Travel Adventures production. This is one of the first state parks set aside to save the redwoods. In 1923, the landowner donated some acreage to the Save the Redwoods League. The park has grown since then. This is long before the Redwood National Park came into existence. This park has a lot of personal meaning to me. When I was 5 years old or younger, our family used to come camping here every summer. The campsites were bigger then and more private, and that's turned into a nature area since then. There are other campsites somewhere else. Before we stopped at the park headquarters, we went and took the road, the side road up to Lost Man Creek Trail, just to show you that on a weekend in the summer, there's still empty places in the park. Most people go to the busy places, but if you want to go somewhere out of the way and go for a hike, you can do that there. Here I am with one of my brothers, sitting on a bench that is a memorial grove for my father. To remember him when he died an early age, we took out this grove, in which case money went to Save the Redwoods League, so it would buy more redwoods and they can make the park bigger. There is some parking at Lost Man Creek Trailhead, and there's some benches there if you want to have a picnic or something. Please hit the subscribe button. Even better, hit the like and leave your comments below. This is where the turnoff is for the park headquarters for Prairie Creek Redwood State Park. Then you stop and make a left turn and come to the park. To the left, you can see the large prairie where they get the name Prairie Creek Redwood State Park. Often herds of Roosevelt elk were there, but they moved to other places, like we saw them down by Fern Canyon. Some people park by the side of the road and walk in. It is a weekend in the summer. So there's a lot of people there. There is a fair amount of free parking. Further in, there's a place where you'd pay and paying for that would also allow you to go into the Fern Canyon route. Just past the park headquarters is the big tree, and there's a little trail into the big tree. It's quite impressive. That is not the only big tree there. There's a lot of big trees, but this one seems to be quite impressive. This is the bridge over Prairie Creek. Back to the prairie. There are some cabins people can stay in, and they have 75 family campsites. Back in the day when I was young, I remember the campfires, and the rangers would leave them, we'd sing songs, they'd tell stories, and they also talked some of the politics, what was going on. There was a lot of pressure from the government to put a freeway through here. And there's three alternatives. One would have put it right through the middle of the park where the headquarters is. That would have really destroyed things the way it is. The other would be going right on the coast where Fern Canyon is and going up that uninhabited part of the coast, and that would have really ruined Fern Canyon. And the other was to go up a hill around 1,500 feet elevation further from the park headquarters and make the freeway there. And that's the one they chose. So the park is still intact and Fern Canyon is undisturbed. You can walk from the park headquarters to Fern Canyon. It's less than 5 miles one way.
are actually pretty big.
Really?
Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video.